That's he taking? Have you ever opened keys here?
Galaxy far, far away. Creatures walked among us, our story begins. Oscar Wilde was doing what he did best, avoiding work. As a clerk, his life was about as dull as it could get, but the one thing he had going for him was the magical guitar given to him by his father. Rumor has it that he won that guitar in a game of chance against a leprechaun.
And the best part about it, now the guitar's mine, I can play any tune I want, because it was his lucky guitar! Oof! Gin Cribbins? What's that? Why, I've never seen anything like it!
And just like that, Oscar Wilde's life was about to become a lot more extraordinary.
It's as if it glows from within. It's amazing.
Oscar was transfixed, as if his eyes were physically unable to look away from the emerald stone. Deep into the stone he gazed, and it started to seem like the stone itself was gazing back at him. The vision surrounded him, and light danced like ripples on a river. He saw a magical session in the stone.
A session is when a group of friends gets together, plays music, sings songs, and dances. And it's the most wonderful thing in the whole world.
Oscar saw musicians like he'd never seen before. Their instruments lit up and light danced while they played. He saw fiddles. He saw a bouzouki. A tin whistle. A harp. A boron. Suddenly, without notice, the vision in the stone ended.
Whoa, that was weirder than that one time at Stone Stock. If I could find a session like that, I would do anything. I would walk 500 miles to make that dream come true.
That night, as Oscar Wilde lay trying to sleep, the vision of the magical session danced in his mind. He wished he could be playing music and laughing and dancing with friends, if only. In that hazy moment between awake and dreamy, Oscar saw the vision of a fiddler. She beckoned him to come. Come, Oscar Wilde, join us. We'll be waiting for you on the Emerald Isle. Join us in Lisdoonvarna.
Lisdoonvarna.
Let the music be your guide.
Thank you.
say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one.
Ah, musicians, always with their head in the clouds.
We are the music makers and the dreamers of dreams, wandering across the lone sea breakers and sitting by desolate streams. World losers and world forsakers upon whom the pale moon gleams. Yet we are the movers and the shakers of the world, forever it seems. Oh, do you have room in there for my jacket? I got some mustard on it.
Yeah? Hello, stranger. But would you like to play a tune with me here? It's called The Irish Washerwoman.
The Irish Washerwoman?
Uh-huh.
Are you the Irish Washerwoman?
Oh, no. She was a powerful goddess who used to take the garments of the brave warriors who are about to go out to die in battle.
To die?
Yeah.
You know, never mind. Never mind about the jacket.
It's no problem.
No, it's okay. It's okay. What instrument is that you play?
I play the tin whistle. It's also called the Scottish penny whistle. The English call it the flageolet. It's the Irish whistle, the Belfast hornpipe. In the old language, it's the Fadoc strine. I call her death.
Okay. I think I get the point. Let's play that tune.
Okay. Sorry, breathing. Let's do that again.
Here called Lisdoonvarna.
Lisdoonvarna? I've lived in this small town my whole life. Lisdoonvarna is a mystery to me. But if you dare, you might ask the Silky of the Sea. She lives down near the crags of Kildare, and she knows about all the magical places.
Thank you.
Lisdoonvarna. Oh, beautiful thing. Well, what is your name, just man?
from Oscar Wilde.
Oh, Oscar Wilde, the great poet and playwright. Oh, I'm such a fangirl. Would you cite my armor?
Oh, not that Oscar Wilde. I get that all the time.
Oh, well, I believe in the importance of being earnest, so I will help you on your quest. What is it you seek?
I had a dream of an amazing fiddler in an amazing session from the land of Lisdoonvarna. Can you show me the way?
Ah, I see. Well, before I help you, I will send you on an arduous quest. You must bring me the tooth of a dragon, and then I will help you find what you seek.
Wait! Whoa. The tooth of a dragon? What do I look like, a dragon dentist?
Well, only the fairies can show you the way. But first, you must play this magical tune to conjure them and gain their favor.
So Oscar Wilde went on his way to the enchanted forest to find the fairies. And he sat next to a big willow tree to rest.
All right, let's see what we have here. All right. With this magical guitar, I can play any tune. Woo! Hello? Fairies? Fairies, do you see any fairies? Fairies, do you see any fairies? I'll try again. This isn't working.
All right, let's help him out, Orchestra. One, two, three. Let's play a trick on this traveler.
Let's send him in the wrong direction.
Well, his trusty guitars never let me down, but today it's no different. And I guess the words that my father used to sing really are true. There are fairies all around us. Prince, but still, I must find this dragon's tooth.
Oh,
The dragon you seek is yonder across that hill to the west of the great castle. He's a great green dragon. But be careful!
He can be very mean and grouchy to strangers.
Well, thank you so much. This is truly a day I will never forget. Fare thee well.
So Oscar Wilde wandered down the road to find the great big green dragon.
Aha, dragon! I've found you, and I've come to take your shoe.
Oh, I'm no dragon, and my dentist says there's nothing wrong with my teeth. I am the Green Man.
What? The Green Man? I've heard tales of old told of the Green Man, but never would I thought I would have met you.
Yes, indeed, and more handsome than my reputation, yes?
Well, I seek the tooth of a dragon. Can you send me in the right direction?
Oh, yes, the dragon. I can point you in the right direction, but to get the tooth, you will have to slay that dragon.
What? Huh? Slay a dragon? I never, what? What, with this old guitar?
Oh, no, no, no. You'll use this axe.
Thank you.
I feel the fire of music in my heart. I can do anything. I'm going for it.
Hold on there. It's going to be a long and harrowing journey, Oscar Wilde. And one more thing. The dragon's that way. Oh. Let the music be your guide.
Thank you.
against the dragon. Back and forth and back and forth they went. But in the end, Oscar Wilde was triumphant and he gained the tooth of the dragon!
Show me where is the road to Lisdoonvarna.
Yes, I do.
Great.
imagined and more magical than even my dream would have said.
We are so glad you're here. Well, at this session, we take turns picking tunes. Is there a tune you'd like to play, Oscar Wilde?
Danny Boy!
Thank you.
there?
This is, I'm his masuki, but I call him masuki.
Oh.
To play.
Oh, Lassie, you know it was called earlier. don't want to do any wars. Therefore, what you wish for that last night.
Celtic harp.
Also known as the clarsac.
The most angelic of all Celtic instruments. Would you play us a tune? Lovelier than the song of the dolphins dance in the rainbow choral. Thank you.
Thank you.
magic in the air. And what an incredible evening it's been. I hope you've enjoyed the adventures we've taken you on, and we hope you go out and find many great adventures of your own. Now as you go out and find new civilizations and boldly go where no one has gone before. Wait. No. This isn't that story. Wait till July 16th for Celtic Light Orchestra presents Space Invaders at Alberta Rose Theater. We'll see you there. As you go out on many wonderful adventures of your own, let the music be your guide.
Thank you.
take a moment to introduce the band, the amazing Celtic Light Orchestra. First and foremost, Mr. Nick Macias, the Globo mastermind, the inventor of the Globo. Second, we have Carmen Everingham, the smart-ass cellist and high school music teacher. We have another local music teacher as part of the group, Roberta Gannett. Big round of applause for the three session kids, Willow, Ajax, and Nathan. Great job! We couldn't have done any of this without Georgia Long, the Irish washerwoman herself, stand up, Georgia. The washerwoman, the whistle, the violin. Great play. And of course, Dr. Jim Imhoff, our mando cello, a right trunk, conductor, vocalist, beautiful singing. Many of the violinists are Katie and my students. Please give a big round of applause to the entire string section.
Thank you for being here. We look forward to seeing you on July